Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to perform selection in the .NET MAUI DataGrid control. I'll also show you how to enable a selection, programmatically selected a row, and customize the appearance of the selected row. I'll also explain how to move the current cell to a particular row column index, clear selected rows, and disable the selection of a particular row. I am using a getting started example application that has been pre-configured with the MAUI DataGrid control and bound order info data source to it. If you want to know more about creating the MAUI app and configuring the MAUI DataGrid to it, you can check the video linked in the YouTube card. Also, you can download the getting started example from the link provided in the description. Now, I launch the application on an Android emulator. Once loaded, tap on any item. As you can see, the tapped items are not selected in the data grid. Now, I will show you how to enable selection. For that, define the selection mode property and set its value to single. Let me run the application. Once loaded, select the first item, followed by the second item. You can see a single item selected at a time. To select multiple items, just change the selection mode to multiple. Now, you can select multiple items in the view. Suppose I want to change the selection mode to single deselect. Simply set the single deselect option here. Now, you can select any item and deselect it by clicking on it again. Next, let me demonstrate how to select a particular row programmatically. To do that, set the selection mode to single and define the loaded event in the data grid control. A new event handler method is created, then navigate to this method. In this method, define the selected row property and set its value to the fifth index item in the order info collection. You will notice that the fifth row is selected. To select multiple rows, set selection mode to multiple and navigate to the event handler method. Here, define the selected rows collection and add the fifth and sixth index items to this collection. Before running the application, remove the single row selected code. Look here, the sixth and seventh rows are selected. Next, let me show you how to customize the appearance of the selected rows. To do this, define the default style property to the data grid and add data grid style inside the default style. To customize the selected items' backgrounds, set the selection background to sky blue and customize the selected row's text color, set the selected row text color to red. Before running the application, remove the programmatic selection code. Once loaded, I selected a fourth item. You can see that the selected item's background and the selected row's text color are changed. Now, let me show you how to customize the currently focused cell border. To change the color and width of the border, set current cell border color to black and current cell border width to 4. Once loaded, select the fourth item, and you will notice that the selected item's border color and width have changed. Let's see how to move the current cell to a particular row and column. To do this, wrap the existing data grid element in a stack layout element and add a new button control with a clicked event above the data grid. A new event handler method is created. Inside this method, let me make a call to the method moveCurrentCell with arguments of the new row and column index as 3 and 1 respectively. Once loaded, I tap on any cell and click the button. You can see that the selection moved to the given row and column index. Kindly note that this method is not applicable when the selection mode is none or navigation mode is row. Next, I will show you how to clear selected items. For that, in the button event handler method, I remove the move current cell to and call the data grid clear selection method. Once loaded, select multiple items and click the button. You can see that all the selected items are cleared. Now let's see how to disable a selection for a particular row. For example, if I want to disable the selection for the fifth row, define the selection changing event, and navigate to the event handler method. Here, add a variable named row and get the first selected item through added rows property. After that, check if the row is equal to the fourth index item in the order info collection. If it is, set cancel to true. Before running the application, remove the button and its event handler method. Now, select the first six rows in the data grid. Notice here, the fifth row is not selected because I disabled its selection feature. Next, let me show you how to navigate between cells. Before running the application, I remove the selection changing event and its method. By default, you can navigate between the cells in a row and in between rows in the data grid. If you want to navigate between only rows, define the navigation mode and set it to row. As you can see, navigate between only the rows. In this video, you learned how to enable selection and select a row programmatically in the data grid, as well as how to customize the appearance of a selected row, disable selection for a particular row, and clear a selected row. Also explained how to move the current cell to a particular row and column index. If you want to see a working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.